To chew over Trump's surge and everything else 2016, I want to bring in CNN senior Washington correspondent Jeff Zeleny. So, Jeff, you have Trump shooting up in the GOP standings. He's trailing Jeb Bush, the son of a president, former Florida governor, by, you know, only a little bit. But to remind our viewers, if you look back to 2011, he led then as well.
He did.
He was even in the first place then. Yeah.
He was. I mean, the difference is now he's actually running and he's actually out there campaigning. It's been a tease for so many presidential cycles. This time he's actually going forward with it, at least for now. But he... Another different thing is he's really diminished himself as the week has wore along here. We've seen all these businesses sort of drop his lines from Macy's to mattresses. But Republicans across the country, governors, senators, are worried about the comments that he's making hurting the Republican brand. The number that sticks in their minds is 40%. George W. Bush won 40% of the Hispanic vote in 2004. Mm. Mitt Romney got about half that.
Right.
So they know that Republicans, to win the White House, need to have about the same amount of the Hispanic vote. And this, they fear, eats away at that, all these negative comments.
Now, I'm going to go out on a limb here. We have a short attention span. Voters do have a short attention span. Is this a lasting phenomenon, the Trump at or near the top of the polls?
I think it's probably not. At this point, it's just sort of an entertainment factor. It's a none-of-the-above factor. You know, he's not a politician. People like it. Once it becomes time to pick a president and say... I do not think that Donald Trump will be scoring quite this high. We've not seen policy positions from him. You know, some Republicans actually think he's a bit of a Democrat in disguise. Mm. How conservative is he really? So we'll
gave
see
a lot of money to the Democrats.
He
was at Hillary Clinton's wedding.
Exactly.
Yeah. So tell me about the Democrats, though. How much are they loving seeing this kind of disarray on the Republican side?
Well, Democrats are being silent about this because they're smiling. I mean, they have nothing to say to this. Why would you sort of insert yourself if you're, if you're a Democrat on this? But look, I think that, they know that this could be good for them long term if the Latino vote sort of goes away from the Republican Party. But I think this fades. This is one of those summer sort of storms that that comes up and moves along pretty quickly.
Another surprise candidate, someone who's in the polls, Bernie Sanders on the Democratic side. He's drawn big crowds where he goes. How much does this shake up the field, and does it at all threaten Hillary Clinton?
Well, I'll tell you, the Brooklyn campaign headquarters for Hillary Clinton is watching Bernie Sanders more carefully than they were before for a couple reasons, a couple numbers in mind. 10,000 people, as we're seeing here. Actually, this is a rally in Colorado a couple weeks ago, thousands. But on just a couple days ago on Wednesday in Madison, Wisconsin, 10,000 people. So why are they doing these rallies in these non-early voting states? I asked one of the advisors. They said, look, it's drawing all this attention, media attention. It's also helping him raise money. That is a key number as we end the week here, $15 million Bernie Sanders raised. You say it's about a third as much as Hillary Clinton, but it's actually as important because his average donation, $33.51. That means you can give again and again and again. So Bernie Sanders is actually out there organically raising money. Hillary Clinton is sort of getting it by big checks here. So, you know, they're not panicked over this at all, but they're watching Bernie Sanders and the liberal wing very closely.
I'm sure he's building up his voter list. Just one very quick question. How many people were at Hillary Clinton's announcement? Anything close to 10,000?
No, around 3,000 to 4,000, and she had about 800 today, just this afternoon in New Hampshire.
That's interesting. Jeff Zeleny, thanks very much.